what that was. Whatever it was, I do see that there's something happening, certainly with the defense. I think that makes me have a Pokemon redux. Like that, the Pokemon in 2019 beating up on bad teams, or in this case this year, teams that, you know, don't have their best players, and then they play a real team and kind of get put in their place. Like, that's sort of what I'm seeing there. But with Mac Jones, the threat, I think, is there to see. I don't know if it's real or not, but it's definitely there. I mean, that to me is an issue, and I just hope you can correct it here before we get to nut gun time, because we're right there. I mean, we're right up against it.
Do you think it's regressing, or do you think it's a rookie wall? Like, is there a difference there? Like, do you think the play is slipping, or do you think maybe some fatigue is setting in?
If he had like a bunch of great games early on in the year, and he was really lighting it up, and, you know, sort of looking like a superstar, and then he hit a couple games like this, I'd say, yeah, it's definitely the rookie wall. But there's two things. Number one, he never did that. He never really had like big games where you're watching him going, ooh, this guy's really going to be something. He had some good efficient games. But other than like Cleveland and Tennessee, I never watched him and thought, oh man, this guy's awesome. So I don't know about the rookie wall. The other thing about the rookie wall is it usually happens like midway through the year. Like, you hit the rookie wall at like week 8 or 9, and that's when Mac Jones played his best football. He played his best football right around when most guys tend to hit the rookie wall. So if he's hitting the rookie wall, he's hitting it kind of late. And that's not great news, I don't think, because the later you hit it, I think the deeper into it you get. Josh McDaniels came out and said, no rookie wall, everything's fine, he's fine, everything's good. And I'd like to believe that, but, you know, this is what it is.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Stuff, not just the bed.
No, that's all they say. We just have to move the bed. If they have to move the bed, it's gonna cost us $1,900.
It's gonna cost.
Have to move the bed.
It costs $200 to move a fucking bed.
Yep.
Yeah, no, we can move the bed.
Yeah, that's what I told them. So it'll be $1,720.
$1,720.
Yeah.
It's not bad.